I don't want this anymore. I don't want this to be part of my life. I don't want this to be part of my unboxings. Hey Grains, today we're going to be asking a really important question. Did they lie to us? A few videos ago, I did an unboxing of Mini Brands, which is a really famous TikTok mystery box. And when I did the unboxing, I got 3 amazing rare, and I think I even got an ultra rare item in there. And don't get me wrong, I am really happy that I got them. But this is what happened after the unboxing video. Dosh Garn Dolly G, I really loved unboxing these mystery Mini Brands. I'm so glad the company sent me a box to check them out. Sent me. And suddenly I got the realization that the company itself sent me these Mini Brands to unbox. So what are the chances that they knowingly put in boxes in there that had rares? Because 3 out of the 10 boxes had something rare, which means a 30% chance. However, when I bought the boxes myself last year, I only got 1 rare in 24 mystery boxes. So unless they change the percentage ratio of rares, this is what we're going to find out today. We're going to unbox 10 more of the Mini Brands and see how many of the rares or ultra rares are we actually going to get. And just to be clear, I bought these myself. But wait, we have a sponsor. But first, let's put our sword gently down and you saw nothing. Today's video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. For those of you who don't know, Raid Shadow Legends is a dark epic fantasy game that takes place in the world of Teleria. In addition to it being
dark epic fantasy,
it also has a really relaxing side to it. I absolutely love the gorgeous character designs and colors. However, there's a really cool new angle that I'd love to show you, Grains. So although a lot of you Grains may have already seen Raid in ads in a few places by now, I wanted to talk to you about something different. This is what makes Raid stand out: the production quality and incredible level of detail. Raid has over 450 unique champions, and every single one is fully animated with the help of their in-house motion capture studio. Mocap is how they get all those super fluid movements and attacks that you see in the game. And they rig each character to move and behave individually. You can see in the way that they hold their weapons, the way they stand, the way they fight, and basically their entire behavior, which I absolutely love. I love seeing behind the scenes of these things. Some of my favorite activities in the game include getting new champions by cracking open shards. And then if I really don't like these characters, all I have to do is sacrifice them to make my current ones even stronger. And of course, sometimes while I'm playing and I have to do something else, the auto battle mode is definitely a saver for time. So I can still get the rewards, but also being productive by doing something else. And not just that, but Raid is constantly updating and adding fun new features and events. So for example, their biggest update ever is currently in development. It's called
Doom Tower.
That's 120 floors in the Doom Tower that are pretty hard with equally difficult bosses, such as the Frost Spider, Magma Dragon, the Tomb Crab, and they all look pretty badass. You know I love monsters, because on this channel,
we do Creatures of Darkness.
You can't just throw yourselves to these bosses. You really have to think of strategies and alliances. I am really excited to try Doom Tower. So what are you waiting for? Check the links in the description box below. And if you're a new player, you will get 100,000 silver, 50 gems, 10 mystery shards, and 1 free champion that is really awesome, Hexweaver. All these treasures will be waiting for you here in your inbox in-game, but only for 30 days. Thank you, Raid, for sponsoring today's video. For those of you who don't know, it is normal practice for people who are toy hunting for mystery boxes or mystery bags, that some of the codes behind those bags and boxes can actually tell you what's inside. So I am really curious if this is the case with these Mini Brands. Are companies sending YouTubers a better percentage of having a rare item to get you Grains hyped? Or did they just naturally increase it? That's what I'm really curious about. And for those of you who don't know Mini Brands, it is a mystery box that has 5 compartments which have known brands of either items, and in previous cases, these items were food items like desserts and cookies and things. brands. And this specific series are known brands of toys. If you're interested in seeing that video, I will link it down below. Let me know in the comment section below, do you think that it was a good percentage that everyone will get? Or do you genuinely think that in the 10 that we will unbox today, we will get no rares or maybe even just one? According to our salt shaker here, which when it's usually optimistic, it will turn green, such as it's demonstrating. Thank you, salt shaker, for demonstrating. But when it's pessimistic, it will normally go red, just like it did right now. Thank you for demonstrating. I appreciate it.
You're very welcome.
It talks now. Interesting. By the way, for those of you new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe, otherwise I may wave a sharp pointy thing at you. Make sure you click on all notifications while you're there. We post twice a week and we goof around here. All right. You saw nothing! I'm not gonna look at it again. All right. I'm gonna get it, hang on. All right. I did it. Let's do the doing. Now, according to the packaging, we should be able to get 60 different collectibles. In the same way that I reviewed the Shopkins Real Littles, I will definitely be giving my opinion on each one. If you're interested to see the Shopkins Real Littles opening, again, down below. Ooh! A Red and Stimpy box. That is really neat. I did not get this one last time. And as you can see, the details on these boxes are absolutely phenomenal. It's a Bobble Booty Stimpy. Very cute. Another truck. So we did get a couple of these in the last video. The fun thing is you can actually open it too. And yes, they are packaged kind of like real toys, but this here is a flexible plastic. Ooh, we are really getting some new ones here. We have a metallic Nickelodeon slime, and unlike the Shopkins Real Littles, these containers don't open, so we don't have a toy on the inside. They are purely for display. What are you? Barbie! Oh no, that's JoJo! I thought it was Barbie! In the previous unboxing, we also got something JoJo Siwa. Again, I will leave that to you grains to watch, but that is really cool. So we have a JoJo Siwa doll head and the description of the toy. I love the fact that they give us a real box. Is JoJo blurry? No, that was just my camera. But yeah, that is really cool. So far, so good. These are really different from the toys we got last time. Next. Ooh, cute little bags. I love these tiny shopping bags because they're paper bags, so it's better for the environment. But also because they genuinely carry quite a few of the toys on the inside, so you really can stuff quite a few. Compared to their shopping carts and their shopping baskets, that's the word I was looking for. You really can maximum put 1.5 items in there, so I like these better. Just to give you a little refresher, what we're looking for is either a gold edition or a glow in the dark edition, and last but not least, a metallic glowy one. Oh, that is very meta. Very cute, I like it. Oh, a Rugrat. I said this last time, but I feel like a lot of this collection is a collaboration with Nickelodeon. So if you are into Nickelodeon toys, cartoons, and products, this is definitely on the right track. We have Angelica, and you can definitely take it out if you want, but I will keep them in the box because I think they're pretty cute. The word cute is probably going to come out a lot today. A Crayola mini watercolor. We've seen this quite often. Oh no, a shopping cart. These are a real pain in the butt to put together. I would probably rather use a Crayola craft kit than have to put these together again. Oh! Yes, I said that. But in case you're wondering, this is what it looks like. Now, ooh, what are you? Ah yes, the teeny genies. My biggest complaint with these boxes is the fact that it's just a box. It's a print of a box that looks cute, but I would much rather have a box with a figurine on the inside, not just a printout. So, I don't want this one. Ooh, miniature Crayola washable markers. And yes, we did get one of these last time. This one, for some reason, is quite smushed. I don't understand how this can happen, especially since it has its own case and nothing in there. And yet, it is crushed.
like my hopes and dreams at thinking of the idea that we potentially will not get any rares.
Am I being dramatic? A little. But yeah, I just don't understand why it would be crushed. But the details and the print in the back of this one is absolutely wonderful. You can see each single word. Crushed, though. No! We get a hula hoop! Very original. It's just a ring. A nose ring. I'm sorry. It's good. We good. Ooh, SpongeBob. We have a karate chopping SpongeBob figure. Box and figure. Again, thank you for that. Another teeny genie. Yes, I knew it! These teeny genies really show up very frequently. In case you want a close-up, that's basically what it looks like.
But we don't want you anymore. Stop showing up. Stop it.
And what are you? Punch balloons? That is weird. Okay, so it is squishy. So I'm sure on the inside there's a kind of foam. But I think these are basically water balloons, at least from what it looks like. And the back says, connect, fill, and make over 100 water balloons. So yeah, it is water balloons. I've never seen these before. By the way, as I'm unboxing, let me know which one is your favorite figure so far. Or you can wait until the end and let me know. I will definitely let you know which one's my favorite, depending if we get a rare. Another hula hoop. Why? Why? I don't need you. And you can't even stay on my nose properly. Let's see how long it stays there. Crayola. As much as I enjoy seeing you, Crayola, I don't want to see you right now. So I'm just going to say, bye-bye. No. Oh, this new. Do you like how I judge things very quickly? I didn't even give it a chance to tell me what it was. I was like, no, I don't watch. But then I was like, wait, you are new. Let's check it out. Oh my God, there's quite a bit of pieces here. And I think, what is that? Oh, that is cute. So it's a little shelf. Let's go ahead and do that. I am impressed. Let me know if your grains are as impressed as I am that this is still staying on my nose. I'm laughing now too. So it's like, it's still there. Interesting. So oh, it's starting to come off now. I'm gonna build a shelf and show you what it looks like. And here it is. This is really easy to put together and I love the details. We have the tiny barcodes right here and the mini brand, so we can put some stuff on there. And just to let your grains know, it fell off as I was building it. Now what's the bet? Is it going to be to scale or not to its own figurines? Place your bets. I'm going to bet no, because it's supposed to have space for two items and the answer is not even one? Really? Can I not? I can't even put one toy. Not even, no. Unless it's like this, which makes no sense whatsoever. A toy on a shelf like this is like one of these people who go into a store and just take something and put it on a completely different shelf. Are you one of the people who do that? Confess. Yeah, that is still one of the biggest issues when it comes to mini brands. If you're going to give us shelves and baskets, make sure that the actual figurines that you give us fit. I mean, look, it doesn't fit this way, nor does it fit that way to go underneath it. And if I want to put it upwards, that's taking the space of two barcodes. So it makes no sense whatsoever. But I do like the shelf. Don't be another teeny genie! No! 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 I said no! I do not want 10 of these! Stop giving these to me! No! Get out of here! I don't want to see you! Another slime. Is it the same? Yes, it is the metallic one that we got previously. I just remembered that one of the slimes here could, in technicality, be a glow-in-the-dark, but there's no other way to find out because right behind it, we have a normal slime, and they look both exactly the same. So the only way to find out whether the one that we got here and these two slimes, if they are glow-in-the-dark, let's go ahead and close all the lights. I'm going to give them all a boost of UV light, so that way if they are glow-in-the-dark, they got some light absorption. All right, Salt Shaker, I also need you to please turn off because all the other lights are off and we can't just have everything open. Thank you for listening. And are any of these glow in the dark? The answer is, oh, these two seem to be, not that one. Can you guys see that? So these two are definitely glow in the dark. That is neat. Just to show you grains the difference, non-glow-in-the-dark and glow-in-the-dark. Look at that. Okay, interesting. So these two are glow. The glow is very faint. The camera that you're seeing it through has exposure on really high. In real life, they barely show.
No! Another cart. I'm not gonna put... Oh, no, this is a basket. They're nice, but I'm not putting it together. It looks like that. Oh, is that new?
This is the non-gold edition of the SpongeBob that we got in the previous video. But again, what's wrong with the boxes? Why are they crushed? Why are they wonky? What's going on? Look at that. What's happening here? But it is a nice toy. I kind of like the non-gold version because we get to see all the different colors. And the rainbow.
No!
You have expectations on you now. Don't disappoint me. You have disappointed me.
Ooh! We get a fingerling, but since it is not a metallic version, it is not one of the rares. And again, this is a toy for your finger, and that's it. Just a toy for your finger. That's all it is. Very entertaining. However, they are cute. I just don't know what's going on with its face. It's almost like some of that plastic came right off. Another Crayola. This time it is not a crushed box, just slightly over here, but otherwise in pretty good condition.
Another Avatar The Last Airbender!
No, why is the box damaged?
Stop damaging your boxes, please.
For those of you who are fans of Avatar The Last Airbender, we get a cute little Aang figurine. And it was my favorite in the past unboxing, so I am glad I get to have two of them. I'll take it out of the box, only if you grains ask for it. So if this video gets 20,000 likes, I will do a YouTube stories unboxing him so that you grains can see him. Oh, another Rugrat. This one is Tommy, and I did get another one of these in the last unboxing. Crayola. At first I was like,
Crayola, I am so happy I got you.
But now I'm like,
Crayola, we meet again.
Yes, and so we have met again.
Get out of here.
And oh, look at that! That is quite a huge figure of Dora the Explorer. And I have to say, it is really cute. I keep saying cute. It's adorable. For those of you who are fed up of me saying cute, it's adorable. Adorable. Get it, Dora. Adorable.
What a joker.
Don't judge me.
You know what? I've judged myself, so you don't have to do it. Technically, I've already done that. Honestly, I love this. This is really awesome. Very nice. And we can see the details. We have Dora here and the description of the toy right in the back, and the text is really clear. Next, what are you?
Is that a robo puppy?
Yeah, that is really awesome. So we have Chipper the robot dog, and it's on the inside. Again, we get the box and the figure. Even though this text over here is visible, the rest is kind of blurry. You can make it out if you really do this. But otherwise, it's hard to see. Same thing with the advertisement in the back. Tells you all the other chippers we can get. I like this. That is really neat. Another SpongeBob, and this one is a double of the one we just got. Are you for real? Do we have to do this again? Are you going to disappoint me? Because if you disappoint me, I just don't know what to do anymore. So let's go ahead, put you nice and snug. Just don't disappoint me. Oh, is that another fingerling? Yes. So here we have a narwhal. I think it's pronounced narwhale, narwhal. I keep saying it wrong and I keep correcting myself, but you know what? If you want to constantly disappoint me, there's nothing I could do about it. All I can say is I'm not mad, I'm disappointed. All this to say, here's the correct pronunciation of this creature.
Narwhal.
And yes, it is another finger puppet, finger toy. You put your finger in the hole and that's basically it.
What?
There's no way to describe this toy without sounding a little off, okay? Don't look at me! Don't look at me like- Don't- Stop! 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 Stop it! I said don't look at me! Another Crayola. This time we have a box of crayons, and they are the 64 colors. And it did say that it comes with a sharpener. Now, where is the sharpener on the side? I don't see it. That is interesting. Unless the sharpener really is... No, that is weird. No, they didn't include it. Unless it's on the inside, but they don't really do anything on the inside. We get some more paper bags. Again, these are my favorites of all the containers because you can put way more inside. So, we have yet to see a gold edition or metallic.
And I feel like in the previous unboxing, we may have gotten a glow in the dark, but we bypassed it. We'll check at the end of this video, which means that we would have gotten 4 limited or rare items. So far, we only got 2, and there's 3 more of these to unbox. But also, let me tell you, Grain, something. These ones are way harder to unpack than the other ones. Because even though the peel back lines are over here, when I try to get to them, look at that. There we go. They just break a halfway and they break them, They just tear and they give me double the amount of work because I have to take out a sharp pointy thing and slice it open. Otherwise I get paper cut and I don't want to do it. So I don't know what's up with that. Look, this is real time. See? You're getting the satisfying version. I'm sitting here like... Yeah, that's how I'm doing it. And I'm sticking to it. We haven't seen a teeny Gina We haven't seen a teeny genie. That's a mouthful. In a few unboxings. So hopefully we don't get to see any of them anytime soon. JoJo! We get a colorful JoJobo. I love saying JoJobo. Try it. JoJobo. It's actually really fun to say. JoJobo. Just rolls off the tongue. I invite you, Grains, to go to JoJo's YouTube channel and tell her, hey, you need to collaborate with Nerdy Crafter Day. I'm so petty. Go, Grains, after this video, go to JoJo's YouTube channel, tell her she needs to collaborate with Nerdy Crafter Day. I don't know why. JoJo's my girl. Unless she's controversial, I don't know about it. Like I said, I don't know, but she my girl. And I do have a ponytail bow video, so feel free to check that out. More paper bags. Oh, that is big. What are you? We have a Myposaur. Oh, that is a really, I was about to say cute. I know you heard nothing though. I didn't say it. That is a really neat packaging idea. So the outside, we have the actual product. This is what it looks like in the back. So the item and, but the text here is really tiny. I am not impressed with this tiny text. Can we even see anything? No. You really have to look very closely. Same thing with the 2 texts on the side. Oh my god. That is near impossible to see. And the other side. But the front has a really cool idea. So we have the flap. You open it and you can see your figurine. Is it in full figurine on the inside? I guess there's only one way to find out, but that is really, really cool. Let's check it out. So is it a full dino? And the answer is, yeah, look at that. So we have our moped dino. Is it a moped dino? Yeah, Myposaur. And yeah, we get the full figure, except that the box in this case is more creative. It's not just the box with an open area like this, it's this. Wait, it's missing its tail. Why you gotta do that? A dinosaur is 1/3 tail. Don't take away a dinosaur's tail. That's 2/3 of a toy. Don't do that. Don't be a teeny genie. Oh, another mini brands. So we're going to check for glow in the dark at the end of the video because I don't want to just keep closing all the lights all the time. Grains, I have to get up, close the light there, and close my 2 other lights here, and then close the other one behind me, and then close the one that is controlled by my phone. That's way too much effort. So I'm going to do that all at the end. I am genuinely surprised we didn't get any of those egg toy things. You'll know them when you see them. We got so many in the last video, almost as many, actually more, like a lot. I think like 6 or 7 of them, but we didn't get a single one this time. More JoJobo. I'm keeping the JoJobo for future My Little Pony customizations. Another narwhal fingerling. I almost slipped and said again. Whoever designed this toy knew exactly what they were doing. So fingerling is what I said. Crayola, and again, the washable markers, except this box seems to be in a better state. More paper bags. I know I said I like paper bags, and I was like, you like it? You take it, stuff it in my face. You like it? Take it, take it again. And another SpongeBob karate chopper. I think this is our 3rd one. This is our 4th SpongeBob in this set. So I don't know what to do with so many SpongeBobs. didn't get a metallic, we didn't get a gold, we got some glow-in-the-darks, but again, I'm pretty sure we got glow-in-the-dark in the previous one. We'll check it out at the end. But this is genuinely our last chance at getting one. I'm pretty sure the salt shaker also feels as skeptical as I am, because this is not working out for us. Yep, I figured. Since this is our last chance, let's put our hands and pray to the unboxing gods. Dear unboxing gods of Evermore, please protect me from opening doubles, triples, and crushed boxes. And also,
stop giving me fingerlings!
Let's see if it worked. Our first one is... What, don't be teeny genie. I said I don't want you! This is... I don't know what more I can say than I don't want this anymore. I don't want this to be part of my life. I don't want this to be part of my unboxings. Another one of the mini brands, but this one is a unicorn. We got this one in a previous unboxing as well. Come on, there's only three left. Rugrats Tommy again. No, another slime. We're gonna find out if this one is glow in the dark. And the last one is usually either a really cool toy or it's going to be a bag or some kind of basket. Please, no. Oh, our fifth SpongeBob. And that's what we got. Let's do our calculation. And so here is everything that we got. Even though we did get quite a few doubles and some repeats from the previous unboxings, there were quite a few new things, including the Dora the Explorer, JoJo Siwa bust. We have also the Ren and Stimpy, some of the Rugrats, slimes, and so on. I would have to say that for this unboxing, my favorite has got to be the JoJo Siwa bust. Don't forget, go to our YouTube channel, tell her she needs to collaborate with me. But I'm starting to really wonder whether or not the packages that they're sending to YouTubers really have a higher chance to open more rare things. Because once you watch the unboxing video, you'll see that I got two super rares in the previous video. Two of them. And one metallic. And here we have the technically glow in the dark, so I'm going to, again, turn the lights off and see if these ones are glow in the dark. We know that two of them are. Let's see if the other two are. I know that one of them isn't. I mixed them up, okay? And in the previous box, I also got this frisbee that many of you grains said it could also be glow in the dark. So I definitely saw those comments. Let's test it out together. And they're all going to get a boost of UV light. And here we go, lights off. And as you can see, out of the four that I thought would have been glow in the dark, only two of them are. And no, the one we got in the previous unboxing, Frisbee, is not, just these two here. Which makes me think, yeah, they're sending YouTubers boxes with higher chance of getting cool stuff. Don't forget to let me know which one is your favorite out of everything that we've opened. And if you want to check the previous unboxing, make sure you check up here. And if you want to watch a Cash or Trash where I get extra salty about things, including the salt shaker light also gets salty with me, check it up down here. Until then, I will see you grains in the next video.